So you want to make sure that you have the rectangles first, because that will block it into perspective. And then you add all the circle shapes afterwards. So let's see what we can do now. Just add some more creative details. We can have some fun with it, have some confidence now, because it looks like the basic shapes of this airplane are now knocked in. Okay, let's see what we can do just to get the edges darkened in underneath the airplane here. And slow it down just a little bit and start to pick the lines that we want to move across. Once again, because we have so many graph lines in there, it's easy to pick lines now to add creative details. So they should work in perspective. So let's just get some confidence going here and get the underneath part of the airplane blocked in and get the curves going. We started with a rectangle, but now we can get some curve shapes and however we like it now to make some creative elements here. So keep locking it into the vanishing points. Just keep knocking that in and see what we can do just to get a feel for the wings and the other shapes that are going to go into the airplane here. All right, I'm going to loosen things up with a soft pencil here because I'm not sure where I want to put the wing. I have a first blocked in shape here, but I need to work on it a bit and revise it. So I'm going to go with a soft pencil again because it's always best to block in the shapes with a soft pencil first. It's always best to block in the shapes with a soft pencil first, and then we add details after that. So let's see what we can do to get a circle shape here into the wing and see what we can do here. So the whole exercise here of drawing the airplane in perspective is to mix up straight edges of rectangles and circle shapes to get some confidence going in our drawings. So if we can hit a rectangle in perspective, we can draw anything. So let's see what we can do to block in the wheels and the wings of this airplane. Okay, here you go. Hit those points and freehand in the circle shape here underneath. If you drew the circle without dissecting the rectangle here, it would be really flat. So this helps you to get some kind of dimension on the drawing here and add to the structure and add some extra details of the lines here. So let's see what we can do on the wing now to get a little shape going into that. So let's hit the vanishing points, start to block it in and see what we can do. Dissect the corners here down the center and hit the other center point here and start to shape, hit those points, and there we go. We got some round circle shapes going on the wing here. Just block in some extra dimension here for some thickness on the wing. But now we can just follow the shape that we want. So you have to be really careful when you make a circle shape in perspective. So we do block it in with rectangles and then we hit those points down each corner, dissect the corners down the center, and then freehand those points. It's the best way to get it in perspective. You have two choices. You could clean it up in computer software if you like, or you could draw into a Cintiq or drawing tablet, and then you can use another level to clean it up. Or if you're actually drawing it on paper, you can erase some of these extra lines once you have the structure all drawn in. Okay, now let's see what we can do just to darken up the lines here. I've got a pen, and it's always good practice to draw with a pen over the line work of the pencil. This will work when you're drawing in a drawing tablet or Cintiq, because you need to draw digital with a pen. So it's good practice to do that. And then also it's good just to get different lines going and get some confidence and draw over the pencil line. So this will help to get some of the details to really stand out. And it'll help to get your confidence going that you can draw over the pencil lines with a pen. So let's see what we can do and just start to knock in some of the details here, being very careful to follow the rough drawings that we have from before. Always follow the roughs that you have and don't vary from that. Just hit it in with the pen here, get the shape in, and let's get some details added in to creatively get this airplane looking original.